not dismayed, whate'er betide, God will take care of you.
Beneath his wings of love abide, God will take care of you.
God will take care of you through every day or all the way. He will take care. God will take care of you.
God will take care of you through every day or all the way.
He will take care of you. God will take care.
Proclaiming your love in the morning and your faithfulness at night, to the music of the 10-string lyre and the melody of the harp. For you make me glad by your deeds, Lord. I sing for joy at what your hands have done. How great are your works, Lord. How profound are your thoughts. May the Lord add his blessings to the reading. Gracious Heavenly Father, thank you for giving us a wonderful day. Thank you for giving us a wonderful principal and loving teachers. Thank you for giving us an opportunity to remember our teachers through this virtual media. Today, as we celebrate Teachers' Day, I pray that you keep all our teachers safe who are taking the extra effort of teaching us through these online classes during this pandemic. Bless our teachers who have given their hearts to teaching. Thank you for the special gift that you've given them. Thank you for the spirit of grace and compassion. We once again bring before you our principal and our teachers. Keep them safe and guide them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Whenever you find something extraordinary, you'll find the fingerprint of a great teacher. They guide us, they support us. They inspire us. They teach us. Today is the day to thank them by wishing them Happy Teachers Day. Good morning to our respected principal ma'am, respected teachers, and my dear fellow students. As we all know, that 5th September, he celebrated as Teachers' Day every year to honor, appreciate, respect, and express a gratitude to the teachers who selflessly work to build the future of the students. The practice started in the year 1962 on the birth anniversary of Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan, who was a teacher, philosopher, and also the second president of India. This year, we are celebrating Teachers' Day virtually because of this pandemic, but nothing can take away our spirit of celebration from us. Our teachers deserve more respect. Their struggles were hard enough even before the coronavirus outbreak. The pandemic hasn't helped. Despite the most adverse circumstances, schools and their management have come together and ensured that no child is left without education, even in these trying times. At War Footing, our school arranged for online classes and ensured a seamless learning experience for all the students. And one of the biggest drivers of the online learning have been teachers, who have adapted to the online mode of teaching and have gone out of the way to prepare online curriculum, presentation for the subject, and much more. All of this just to ensure that continuous seamless education is imparted to the students. Here, we all salute our teachers who have always been working really hard and tirelessly to make sure children's learning should go on no matter what. Our dear teachers deserve much more love, respect, and care, and a little time for themselves too. We love you, teachers. Thank you for everything.
Education is not the filling of a pail, but the lighting of fire. These great words were said by the famous Irish poet, William Butler Yeats, and our teachers definitely are the igniters of this knowledge and wisdom in all of us. Teachers are the ones who mold our lives and our personalities. They not only give us knowledge, but also shape our imagination to build a better future for ourselves. Our Honorable President APJ Abdul Kalam had said that the role of teachers is one of the roles that he had cherished the most among the roles he played in his life. When we set foot in this hallowed and holy institution, we were all truly fresh clay in your hands, and it was your very magic that transformed us into the beautiful sculptures that we are meant to be. You removed the unwanted habits and the imperfections in us and let only the good values prevail in us. You have all played a pivotal role in laying a strong and robust foundation in our lives. Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Gurur Sakshat Parabrahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, is what is enshrined in our ancient scriptures. And as per this, Guru or teachers come before God, and such is the importance that teachers have in our lives. A teacher plays the role of a mother, father, friend and a guide simultaneously. Teachers, you are our sunshine, without which our lives would have been dark alleys. Today we would like to thank you for inspiring us, igniting our minds and instilling in us a love for learning. Our parents gave our lives, and it was the teachers who molded our lives to be bright, young and happy. You have instilled in our character honesty, integrity, passion, and taught us to be responsible citizens of this rich nation. Thank you for chiseling our character and playing the role of a divine alchemist in our lives. We shall forever be grateful for all your sincere, nurturing and caring efforts. The respect that we shall have for you in our lives shall never go undiminished, and shall only soar high as we carry forth in our journey ahead. World shall face to account and express our sincere gratitude for all the wonderful things that you have implanted in us. We shall carry your essence and teach and your teachings as we chart out our respective destinies. We are truly indebted to you and grateful to you, and shall remain so forever. We shall revere your presence in our hearts and the fragrance that you implanted in us throughout our lives. Thank you, teachers. Happy Teachers Day.
That's a hard question.
A world without teachers.
What would the world be like without teachers?
Chaos.
Sad. Because I won't learn anything.
The younger generation wouldn't have anyone to look up to learn from.
Walk around ignorant.
I mean, we could keep the teachers, but just no homework. That'd be pretty cool.
Everybody would be going cuckoo and we wouldn't know anything.
I think that is the scariest thought that anyone could ever have.
I think it would be craziness, just because I feel like teachers are, besides our parents, the first people we meet who like shape who we become.
I haven't always been like the best student throughout my whole life.
I was always in trouble.
I had suffered 3 Fs, and I realized like, oh, whoa, I need to fix that, you know?
Fourth grade was over, I'm here 5th grade, we graduate, 6th grade. Hey, Ms. Gonzalez, how you doing? And then she's like, oh yeah, I heard these are your grades. What's going on in that science class? Like, she was like totally just keeping up, and I just felt like, whoa, like something's different about that.
Gave me the time of day, mostly. It was very engaged in stuff that I was doing. Even though I was in detention, I was still learning.
And she was the one teacher who really saw a lot in me to make me feel like I wasn't the kid that other teachers were saying.
And there was a point where I said, okay, I'm gonna fail my French class because I haven't been there. So I haven't done any homework. I'm just gonna drop out before I fail. And then she specifically came to me and said, no, I'm gonna work out a deal with you so that if you stay, you won't fail.
We didn't do good at school. She would chew you out, but she would always give you a chance to make it up. You know what I mean? She would never put you low standard and just leave you there. You know, and that's one thing I like about teachers. You know, they won't leave you behind.
The light of the world, the beacon in the dark, and the hope that gives students strength to survive is our teacher. A day kept aside to honor the gifted souls who work every day to make sure that the future is bright for all their students. Teachers spearhead change by shaping and building students' personality and make them ideal citizens of the country. Apart from academics, teachers stand by the students at every step to guide, motivate, and inspire them to become better people. One child, one teacher, one pen and one book can make change in the world. A quote by the daughter of a teacher, Malala Yousafzai. Rightly so, teachers are the first guiding steps in this big competitive world. Without a mentor over their heads, a guide to distinguish right from wrong, students will be bodies without spirit. While growing up, the only person students tend to respect after the parents are their teachers, because greatest lessons are learnt in the classroom. Teachers' Day is celebrated every year on 5th September. It is on birth anniversary of Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan. Dr. Sarvepalli Radhakrishnan was the second president of independent India, a distinguished scholar and an excellent teacher. This day is a special day for students to express love and respect for their teachers, and they honor them with their genuine and warm wishes. Teachers are the architect of the society and guiding light for the nation. Dear teachers, during this pandemic, you stood your ground. You did not give up. Adapted yourselves to the need of the hour by training yourselves to equip yourselves with the use of technology and get on with the virtual classes so that every student is reached out to. You opened your homes to cater to the teaching, coaching, mentoring that a student needs in the midst of these most trying times. On behalf of the management, students, administrative, support staff and myself, wish each one of you joy and happiness. You deserve the best. You are the spark, the inspiration, the guide, the candle to your students' lives. Continue to be kind, patient, and inspire, motivate your students to bring out the best in them. God bless you all. A very happy Teacher's Day to each one of you. Thank you.
just because I want to.
On behalf of Baldwin Boys High School family, I congratulate you this day for choosing this profession. Teaching is the profession that teaches all of the other professions. I will tell you a strange fact. In all my years of growing up, I must have sat through many classes and had learned many lessons, but not a one comes to my mind. I can't remember my lessons, but I can't forget my teachers, especially those who were strict and bitter. Teachers also don't forget their children. After many years, I went to my school. That was last year. I took my wife and kids, showed them how our days were. I used to cross a river and come to school. Those were the tough days. I showed my kids the river that I used to cross and explained them how difficult it was. If there was heavy rain, we bunked our classes, and teachers also knew that few students won't come today. I met my teacher. He was my math teacher. I just asked him, "Would you recognize me?" And that was after 35 years I was visiting my school. He looked at me for a while and said, "Are you Ravi? See how they remember you. One child, one teacher, one book, one pen can change the world, isn't it?" Somebody sent me this. At the entrance gate of a university in South Africa, the following message was posted for contemplation. Destroying any nation does not require the use of atomic bombs or the use of long-range missiles. It only requires lowering the quality of education and allowing cheating in the examination by the students. Patients die at the hands of such doctors, building collapse at the hands of such engineers, money is lost at the hands of such economists and accountants, humanity dies at the hands of such religious scholars, justice is lost at the hands of judges. The collapse of education is the collapse of the nation. Happy Teachers' Day. God bless you.